The Emperor's sword will lead the attack. If the information from our spy is correct.
It is?
Then Sector 47 is of the greatest importance to the Federation. Star bases along that border are designed for nothing but research. They will have no chance.
Your flank is exposed. Coming in from those coordinates will leave Captain Colt completely defenseless on his left side.
That is where you come in. Your ship will be waiting behind his asteroids. As soon as Emperor's sword goes past, you swing around and block his rear.
I will not be kept to the rear. This is a foolish plan devised by a foolish woman. I will not be.
Ah, but you see, it is not my plan. This was devised by my commanding officer, Captain Carr.
You were voicing an opinion about tomorrow's battle plan?
Only that it won't work. Starbase 33 is a mining colony.
Ugh. Dirt diggers. Tired and bent over from working all day.
Dilithium mines. A convoy of starships is due to protect their next shipment.
They will arrive about the same time you will.
The convoy will be delayed. Planet Markham 6 will find itself the target of several terrorist attacks. Millions will be killed. The starships will have no choice but to divert from convoy duty.
I'm impressed.
You should be. Captain Karg is one of our greatest strategists. He is the only man to ever survive the final simulation exam at the Klingon training compound.
Is this true, Captain? Surely there must be some story to tell. An epic poem. Or perhaps an opera.
It is called the Test of Victors. And what a test it was. It seemed like we have been fighting for an eternity.
Coming around again, sir.
Of course he is. The stubborn imbecile. Well, fire, you fool!
He simply would not give up. Kang. Kor. Koloth. And Kar. It was going to be glorious.
So you blasted a defenseless ship. What happened?
That did it, Captain.
Coil emissions, negative.
Power readings, negative.
Propulsion, negative. Life signs.
They're dying, sir.
Open a channel. I am Captain Karg. You have fought well. Your death at the hands of the Klingon Empire will surely bring honor when you face your ancestors. Stand by to be destroyed.
Captain, at least give me a moment to prepare my crew.
Very well. You have been a worthy adversary.
We can destroy each other here and now. Is that what you want?
Emergency warp! Get us out of here now! Talk to the fleet! Evasive maneuvers! I repeat, take immediate!
They're all dead.
Kang. Kor. Koloth. Dead.
In a simulation? Yes.
But not you.
You've always been one of my finest students. But even I did not believe that you could beat the test of victors. Captain Karg.
They promoted me on the spot. gave me 2 months leave wherever I wanted, and my choice of commands when I got back.
Captain, if I may speak freely.
Speak, but choose your words carefully.
In the simulation, Kor, Kang, Koloth, they all died honorably in combat. But you...
He ran. You dishonored yourself.
Perhaps. But the High Command regards one captain's loss of personal honor preferable to the loss of an entire ship and her highly trained crew. It is a thin parallel between a soldier of the Empire and the captain of a Federation starship. The simulation is not about how you die, or even if you die.
It's about facing death.
Outsmarting death, making him come to you like a familiar enemy until the day you choose when and where to face him.
I agree, Kapla.
Kirk to Enterprise.
Did you get all that?
Indeed we did, Captain. Every word.
And Starfleet should have no problem averting the trouble at Markham 6.
Very well, then. Tell Mr. Sulu to set a course for Starbase 33 and have Mr. Kyle prepare to beam you aboard.
Aye, sir.
Kirk out.